So I go to my main method and I will do a string player name initialize to empty. I will do the boolean game over and we'll initialize it to false because we keep playing. And over here I will create players. So it will simply say console dot write line enter player one name. Alright, so it will, this is the player one, it asks for the name, and it will do player name equals console dot read line. We don't have to convert anything, it's a string. So, and now we can create the player. So tic-tac-toe, that's the class of tic-tac-toe, this one that we were creating so for like 50 minutes now. So this is the player, I'll just call it player one, equals new tic-tac-toe, and remember I'm passing the integer, the number of the player's number and player's name. So that's why I said for player one, the integer is one. We are manually passing it. This is something for the internal use for the computer. Player name is the second parameter that we are passing into the constructor, which is the name. Now we will do console.WriteLine enter player two name. And over here I will simply say something like type computer if you want to play against computer. Okay, and this is gonna be again player name equals console.readline, and we will create the second object. I'll copy that. So it's gonna be player two, and so we pass the integer two and player name. So now we have both players, could be computer, could be another player, depend on if it's a computer, you know, like I said over here, we check against that, we check if it's a player's name is computer. If it is, the functionality is different, that's why we use all the if else statements. So we have the players, and now we can do the game loop, which is a simple while, not game over. So while not the game is not over, and that's why our main function play game is returning true or false. It will simply return whether the game is over or not after each turn. So, and if it's not, then we keep playing. So what we do, we will have to initialize, we will initialize the board. Remember, this is a static method. So where is our board? How would I call it? Init board. It's a static method, so I don't call it from, you know, from any of the objects. I call it directly from the class. So tic-tac-toe dot init board, and this is populates the board with zero. Now we want to display this only once, you know, at the beginning, not each time the, you know, any of the players takes turns. So over here we will do another loop, another while loop, and this one it will be while not player one, this one is with the objects, play game, not player game, play game, that's the function, and not player two dot play game. The game over equals true. All right. So what this does, so basically what we here what we're doing, we keep calling the play game over and over again until or while it returns false. In other words, while it is not over, while the game is not over, we will keep playing. And the game is over whether either for when player one returns true, or when whether player 2 returns true. And true is returned either for the win or for the draw. Okay, so either player 1 wins, or the player 2 wins, or it's a draw. Until then, we'll be looping and going, basically what we are doing here, going through, play this function over and over again until it returns true. It, in other words, it returns false. Comes over here. Okay, one of them returned false, so keep looping, basically. All right, so we keep looping until the game is playable, until it is not a win or a draw. Now, when it is, if it returns true, in other words, one of them will not be false anymore, in other words, one of the players wins or it's a draw, then the game over is true. So that's we declare this true to get out of this loop. But before we do that, we ask the player whether he or she wants to play another game. So if game over, so if it is a game over, and we will ask whether to, well, we can do something like a console.WriteLine, do you want to play another game, press escape to quit, and any other key would be to continue. So we check the input. So if, and to check the input is the console.readKey, and if it returns true, if the key that we are looking for returns true, and in our case the key equals console key dot escape. So in other words, if the user presses escape, then this returns true, and we know that the user pressed escape. So we will simply say console dot write line and something like goodbye. Yeah, the game's over. And if the user didn't press escape, if he pressed anything else, we will declare the game over as false. So now it will come back over here, and the game over is still false, so it will initialize the board for another game. Okay, so over here I will do console.readLine to pause the screen at the end so we can read it. And I think this might be all. So you know what, let me run it and let's see what's happening. And it's building, and it didn't build. All right, so what do I have? I have a bunch of errors, actually. Okay. Oh, geez, I forgot all the semicolons here. Not there. Not the semicolons, but the parentheses. Oops. In all of these, because I just copy-pasted them, so now they're all wrong. Oh well. And one more. All right, let's see if it builds now. And that was just my dog shaking. All right, so let's say my name is player one, and Peter would be player two. So here is our board, our initial board. And I will do coordinates 1 and 1, which would be supposed to be this corner, this 0. So let's see if it can put 1 in that place. And here it is, 1, 0, 0 now. So it's player's 2 turn, and it's going to press, let's say, 3. Let's say it presses 5, wrong coordinates outside of the board. So it says wrong coordinates. So how about 6, 6, still wrong. All right, so how about 3 and 3, which is the other corner, and now we have 1 and 2 in each corners. All right, so I'm going to do 1 and 2. So I have 2 of these, and he can do, let's say, 2 and 2, which would be the middle one. And I'm going to win, so I'm gonna have 1 and 3, and it says, hey, congratulations, Pavel, you win another game. I said, yeah, why not? So I just press enter, and it initialized the board back to zeros and asked her to place another symbol. So I'll start with, let's say, 2, 2, which is my the middle, and it didn't ask for the names because it, you know, it's the same players. It keeps going again and again. So now the symbol will be, let's say, 3 and 1, which should be the Fredero, the first element, which is, so now we have that. And I will do, I don't know, well, 2 and I'll do 2 and 2 again. So it's already taken. So let's see if it's gonna take it. No, wrong one. So how about 3 and 1? No, it's already taken. So how about 1 and 1? Okay, that's over. Now I have 2 of these. So I let the second player win now. So I will do 3 and 2. And I will do 1 and 2. And now I will let the second player win. So it's 3 and 3. Yay, congratulations, Peter. You win. So now we go and let's press escape. And it should start to say goodbye and quit. And yeah, it is goodbye. Now, let me just check one more time. I want to check the across if it considers it to win. So I go, I'm sorry, 0 and 1. And, oh, something went wrong. Index was outside. Okay. Let me try it again. So, player's name is Pavel, the other name is Peter, and I will do, oh, because when I say 0 and 1, it take, okay. See over here, we are only checking if it's greater than 3. We're not checking if it's actually 0 or less. So over here it should say, or R is less than 1, or C is less than 1. So now when I do that, it should give me a message saying that the coordinates are wrong. So I will do 0 and 1. Yeah, incorrect coordinates. So, all right, so 1 and 1, that's correct. And I will do the other player 1 and 2. And 2 and 2. And, I don't know, 1 and 3. And finally, what was it? 3 and 3, and we got a winner. It is a cross. So I will play another game, and this time I will try to make it a draw. So 1 and 1, 1 and 2, 3 and 1, and 2 and 1. I want to make sure that no one wins. So 1 and 3, and 2 and 2, and I will do 3 and 2. Okay, and 3 and 3. All right, and so no one wins. And now I will do 2 and 3. We have a draw. It's a draw. It's full, but no more moves available. So I will press escape, goodbye. And we can, now finally, let me check it against the computer. So I will do the Pavel and computer. So Pavel goes first, and I will do 1 and 1. And the computer randomly assigns, you know, something. So I will do 1 and 2. Computers again randomly assign something. I will do 2 and 1. I'm trying to let the computer win, but I don't think that's gonna really happen. And I don't know what. Something is happening. Oh, I think it's trying to find a. Oh, it seems like it's looping. Oops. Seems like it's looping like forever. For the computer. All right. And honestly, the reason for that, I think it's the way it picks the random numbers. It just keeps looping and looping because, and it cannot find a different number, which means, you know how the random numbers are based on the system clock. In other words, these random numbers are too quick. They're the same over and over and over again. It, and once it finds some that already taken, when we go to check the board, the R and C just keep repeating. It's the same numbers over and over again. If they're taken, it just keeps saying, okay, try another one, another one, another one, and it can't because it's the same numbers. So what we can do, we can split them. We can do assign the first one, but the second one, we can put a little loop around it. Something like integer I equals 0. And I is less than 5,000, for example, and I plus plus. This is basically to buy some time before the next number is being assigned. Because so this one is assigned, and but it will take a little bit longer. In other words, the time, the system clock will kind of have time to move in order for the random number to be different from the R. Over here we'll do the same thing. This is just the only reason why I'm doing this is this way. It's really just to, like I said, buy the time. Now let me check that. Let me see if the 5,000 is enough. If I enter Pavel and computer and one for me. Computer did over here, it's a 3 and 1, so I'll do 1 and 2. Computer picked some, I will do, I don't know, 2 and 1. Computer picked some, I will do 2 and 2. Computer picked some, and now I'm going to win. It's gonna be 3 and 1. It's gonna be 3 and 3. And congratulations, Powell, you win. So let's play again. I will do again 1 and 1. And 2 and 2, and I don't know, 1 and 3. The computer's never gonna win. And 1 and 2. It's already taken, so 2 and 1. And finally, I will say 3 and 2. So it's a draw. I'm trying to, but you can see that the computer now doesn't loop infinitely. It has time with this loop. Gives it, in other words, it creates 5,000 different random number, and the last one it creates is the one that is used. But that's the way we get extra time before getting random number for R and random number for C. So I will play just one last game. I will do 1 and 1, and 1 and 2, and I don't know, 3 and 1, and maybe 3 and 2. Hey, and computer wins. He got the raw over here. So it seems to be working now. Of course, feel free to test, because there's more to it than this probably. Again, if you feel exceptionally good, you can try the three-dimensional array, like they ask us to do in the assignment, when they say three-dimensional tic-tac-toe on 4x4 board. But I'm not gonna do that. So this is my solution, and I hope it was helpful, that you maybe even learned something. That would be great. And I'll